Hi students, we are looking at the 10th standard mathematics chapter 1, that is relations and functions. This is where we stopped in the last class. Okay, f of minus 1.5, what is minus 1.5? It is in between minus 1 and minus 3, so minus 2.5, right? Okay, f of 2 plus f of minus 2, minus 2 falls here, f of 2 falls here. Okay, this is 4 and this is minus 3. Yes, 4 minus 3 is 1, so it is going to be 1. Okay, going to be 1. So function is defined as follows. You can find these values similarly, okay, with the same approach. The distance as an object travels under the influence of gravity in time t seconds is given by s of t equal to gt square plus at plus b, where g is the acceleration due to gravity. A and b are constants. Verify the function s of t is 1 to 1 or not. Okay, time is always positive. If you take time always positive, if you are not taking negative numbers, then I think it will be 1 to 1. Okay, for any given number, you will not get two values, so it is 1 to 1, no problem. Okay, then if you take time to be negative, still I doubt. Because AT part is also there, okay, but time can never be negative. So if you take everything is to be positive, I don't think you will get some other value here. For that means you will get same value for two inputs, okay, right? Otherwise you assume in the other way around, by taking like this 0.5 g, take two values, okay, let's say x and y, x square, x and y are the two values where the function is equal, okay, and see whether that is possible or not. That is how you have to check this, but in this case I doubt whether we can proceed in this way or not. Why? Because the constant values were not given, so bb will cancel out. That is pretty simple. Then this thing will lead to what? 0.5g you can take common. 0.5 g, you can take common. If you take that common, this becomes x square minus y square equal to what? Equal to what? A into x minus y, or minus a into x minus y, right? By y being positive, x being negative, when you shift this to this side, x square minus y square can be written as x plus y into x minus y, so both will cancel out, particularly. So this becomes x plus y, and this becomes minus a, right? So x plus y, if x plus y can be equal to this is the condition for which for the two values x and y, the function is going to be equal. Okay, that is what we are trying to get at, right? Minus 2a. Alright, a is there, yes, minus 2a, right, up to here there is no problem, by g. Alright, जी वैल्यू इज 9.81, दैट इज पॉजिटिव. ओके, इफ ए इज नेगेटिव देन ओनली दैट इज पॉजिबल, राइट? टाइम कैन नेवर बी नेगेटिव. ओके, इफ द एक्सेलरेशन इज अ नेगेटिव नंबर, सॉरी, ए इज ऑल्सो ए कॉन्स्टेंट, सॉरी दैट्स माई मिस्टेक. A and B are two constants, that is what he told, and the values of the constants, there is no restriction whether it is going to be positive or negative. So if you take A to be negative, yes, there is a possibility, so this is not a 1-to-1. Okay, that's how we can conclude it. If you give the particular values of A and B, you can easily assess from the equation itself. Okay, so this is the condition, that means at these values of x and y, okay, because the sum it should be positive because the time value should never be negative. If a can be negative, okay, if a is negative for this particular value of x plus y, their sum, the result is going to be same. Okay, so that tells us that this is not 1-to-1 when A is negative, okay, right? So we can clearly state that it is not 1-to-1, okay? Let's see this 12th one. The function T, which maps temperature in Celsius to the temperature in Fahrenheit, is given like this, the famous formula. Find T of 0, that means temperature in Fahrenheit when C degree in Celsius. This becomes 32. This becomes 32 degree Fahrenheit. 28, you can substitute 28 here and find. -10 also you can substitute and find. -10, it is pretty easy. If you can easily divide by 5, that is -2, -18. -18 means reduce 20 from here, 12, so 14 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so the value of C when T of C is 212, that also you can find by substituting this equation on the left hand side and doing the simple mathematical operations on it. Okay, addition and division, like that, multiplication. The temperature when the Celsius value is equal to the Fahrenheit value, is that possible? I wonder whether it is possible when both are equal. Substitute here also C minus 32. Let's let's find it out. How to find it out? I need to move this thing here because I will get space here. Then I can equate whether that is possible or not. I'm going to look at here. C minus 32 equal to 9/5 into C. I'm just equating. I took both for Fahrenheit and Celsius, C only. Otherwise you can take X also, that doesn't matter what you take. So 5C minus 32 into 5 is what? 5 2 is a 10, 5 3 is a 15, 160 equal to 9C. 9C. See? So 9 minus 5 is 4C. 4C equal to minus 160. C equal to minus 40. So this is the temperature where both are equal. Is that correct? You can check again. Put minus 40 here. This becomes minus 72. Minus 72 plus 32 minus 40. Okay. Right. So that is, you can straight away write the answer here, minus 40 degree or minus 40 degree Fahrenheit. At this temperature, both values are equal. Okay, Now we are going to look at composition of functions. When a car driver depresses the accelerator pedal, it controls the flow of fuel, which in turn influences the speed of the car. Likewise, the composition of two functions is a kind of chain reaction where the function act upon one after another. We can explain this further with the concept that a function is a process. If f and g are two functions, right, then the composition g of f of x is formed in two steps. Feed an input, say x, to f like this, f of x, and then feed output f of x as input to the another function, then this becomes g of f of x, okay? Right, consider an example. The set of A is a set of all students who appeared in class 10th of board examination. Each student appearing in the board examination is assigned a roll number. In order to have confidentiality, the board arranges to deface the roll number of each student and assigns a code number to each roll number. Okay, right. Let A be the set of all students appearing for the board exam. B is a subset of N. Okay. B is a set of roll numbers. C is also a subset of N. B is a set of all code numbers. Okay. This gives rise to two functions, f from A to B. Okay. Student to roll number. This is one function. Second one, G. Is a code number function. B to C is a code number function. B is f of A. B the roll number assigned to a student. F of A is the roll number assigned to the student A. C is G of B. B the code number assigned to the roll number B, where A belongs to A, B belongs to capital B, C belongs to capital C. We can write C equal to G of B. What is B? B is f of A. B is in turn is a function of A. Okay. Thus, by the combination of these two functions, each student is eventually attached a code number. This idea leads to the following definition. What is the definition? Let f is a function of function from A to B and g is from function to B to C. Be the two functions. Then the composition of f and g denoted by GOF, that means G of F, okay, is defined as the function G of F of X, okay, for all X belongs to A. Find FOG, GOF when F of X is 2X plus 1 and G of X is X square minus 2, okay. Which one you want to go with FOG, F of G of X. Okay, what is g of x? X square minus 2. So here you have to place x square minus 2. Now you have to go back to f of x is 2x plus 1, right? So in place of x, what is there? X square minus 2. Substitute this x square minus 2 in place of x and find the value, that is f of g of x. What is g of f of x? What is f of x? 2x plus 1. So this is this becomes g of 2x plus 1. What is g of x? X square minus 2. In place of x, you have to put 2x plus 1. Okay, so FOG, GOF are not equal. Okay, that was the conclusion. If f of x is x power m and g of x is x power n, does both are equal? I think so, because g of x is x power n, x power mn, this becomes x power mn, and this becomes also x power mn. Okay. Generally, FOG not equal to GOF for any two functions f and g, so composition of functions is not commutative. Okay, or represent this function as a composition of two functions. This is f2, this is f1. Okay, f of x is this, so root of f2 of x, so otherwise f1 of f2 of x. Okay, if f of x is g of x, then find the value of k, that you can find k if f of f of k is 5 and f of where f of k is 2k minus 1. That also you can find. Composition of three functions. Now we are going to look at the composition of three functions. Let a, b, c, d be four sets and let f is function from a to b, g is function from g to b to c, h is function from c to d. Be three functions using composite functions fog, goh. We get two new functions like fog of h, f of goh. We observed that the composition of functions is not commutative. The natural question is about the associativity of the operation. Composition of three functions is always associative. That is, f of g of h is nothing but f of g of h. Okay. Let's verify this. Okay. Verification process is here. You can go through this. Okay. This can be written as GFF also. Okay, that is G of f of x. Okay, FGG means f of g of g of x. State your answer. The composition of function is not commutative, is commutative, never, sometimes true. Okay, composition of function is associative. Yes, it is associative. Where is this? Given that h of x equal to f of g of x, fill in the table for h of x. F of g of x. Okay. Right. F of g of x. Put the value of x here. What is g of x? For x equal to 1, g of x is 2. Okay. For this 2, it is 3. Okay. For 2, this is 4. For 4, this is 4. So, here it will be 4. For 3, it will be 3. For 3, it is 1. So, here it is 1. For 4, it is 1. For 1, it is 2. So, this is 2. Okay. Like that. Identifying the graphs of linear, quadratic, cubic and reciprocal functions. Okay, graphs provide visualization of curves and functions, hence the graphs help a lot in understanding the concepts in a much efficient way. In this section we will be discussing about identification of some of the functions through their graphs. In particular, we discuss graphs of linear, quadratic, cubic and reciprocal functions. First, linear function. Function defined from real numbers to real numbers. No, rational numbers to rational numbers. No, real numbers to real numbers. Defined by f of x equal to mx plus c, m not equal to 0 is called a linear function. Geometrically, this represents a straight line in the graph. Okay. Some specific linear functions and their graphs are given below. The identity function f of x equal to x. This is a linear relation between f of x and x, that is result and the input. Additive inverse function, that is minus x. This is also a linear relation. You can see the graph also. F of x equal to mod x. Here also the graph shows the linear relation, right? So modulus function is not linear function, but it is composed of two linear functions. This is one linear, this is another linear function, okay? Functions x and minus x. Linear functions are always one and one to one functions and has applications in cryptography as well as in several branches of science and technology. Quadratic function. A function f r to defined by f of x equal to x square plus bx plus c, a not equal to 0 is called quadratic function. Some specific quadratic functions are f of x equal to x square. This is the graph. F of x is minus x square and this is the graph. The equation of motion of a particular particle traveling under the influence of gravity is a quadratic function of time. These functions are not one to one because of the square property. For the same value of x, for different values of x, they may get the same result. That's why they are not quadratic. क्यूबिक फंक्शन, फंक्शन इज दिस ए एक्स क्यूब प्लस बी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस सी एक्स प्लस डी, वेयर ए शुडंट बी जीरो इज कॉल्ड क्यूबिक फंक्शन। द ग्राफ ऑफ क्यूबिक फंक्शन इज लाइक दिस। ओके, रेसिप्रोकल फंक्शन, ए फंक्शन आर माइनस जीरो ओके इज डिफाइंड बाय एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू वन बाय एक्स, जीरो शुडंट बी इंक्लूडेड। ओके, इज कॉल्ड रेसिप्रोकल फंक्शन। ओके, रेसिप्रोकल, दिस इज द रेसिप्रोकल नेचर। ग्राफ, कॉन्स्टेंट फंक्शन इज वाट एवर मे बी द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स, द वाई वैल्यू इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टेंट, एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू सी, दैट इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट फंक्शन। इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट फंक्शन लीनियर फंक्शन? नो, देर इज नो रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इनपुट एंड द आउटपुट, दैट्स वाई कॉन्स्टेंट फंक्शन इज नॉट अ लीनियर फंक्शन। इज क्वाड्रेटिक फंक्शन ए वन टू वन फंक्शन? नो। Is cubic function a one-to-one function? That you can see here. Cubic function, is it one-to-one? Appears so. Right, that appears as a one-to-one function. But you can always cross-check. Okay. X cube. Minus y cube should be equal to 0. When that is possible, a cube minus b cube, a minus b into a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. When a square plus ab that means x square plus xy plus y square equal to 0, then there is a possibility. X square plus xy plus y square. Yeah, there is a possibility. So we cannot deny that, because x square plus xy plus y square. If you are only talking about the positive values. Yes, it is a single valued function. If you need to talk about the negative values as well, then there is a chance, I guess. Whenever that satisfies that equation, okay? All right. Is a reciprocal function is a bijection. That you need to verify. If f is a to b is a constant function, then the range of f will have dash elements, only one element. Exercise 1.5. We will stop it here. We will continue from the exercise 1.5 in the next session. Okay. Nandri, vanakkam. See how beautiful this nature is. You also start planting the trees. Let us bring a new change in our society. Let us plant the trees and let others plant the trees. Let's take this pledge seriously from now. Thank you.